As platform engineers, it's our job to make developers' lives easier. This is a two-part series of videos. Today, we'll talk about the platform engineer persona as we dive into how GitOps is revolutionizing infrastructure management. Using Backstage, Crossplane, and ArgoCD, we'll automate the creation of GKE clusters, showcasing a seamless, code-driven approach to infrastructure. In part two, I'll switch hats and show how you deploy a Go API from a template on Backstage, so stay tuned for that video. For now, let me put on my platform engineering hat and let's get going. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started and see what we're going to build. So we've got Backstage and I have it running in a Kubernetes cluster. And inside of Backstage, I have a GKE cluster template that we're going to use. What will happen is once we select this GKE cluster template, it's going to trigger a GitHub Actions workflow. This GitHub Actions workflow is going to reach out into my infrastructure Kubernetes cluster. And by the way, I have Backstage running in the same cluster. So what's going to do is that the Actions workflow is going to create an ArgoCD app by calling my ArgoCD deployment inside of this cluster. What will happen is ArgoCD is going to generate a claim into Crossplane, which also runs inside this infrastructure cluster. And what will happen is Crossplane is going to go out and create a cluster and a node pool using a composition. And this will generate my GKE cluster for apps. Now, if you're interested in how Crossplane does this, I have a separate video which you can take a look at and learn a lot more about this topic. That's pretty much it from a what we're going to build perspective. Let's dig in and see how the demo works. This is a quick announcement that I'm working on two new courses. One is Backstage 101 and the other is Crossplane 101. They're both a work in progress as of this recording, but maybe by the time you watch this video, they'll be ready to go. You can always check the TechInAid Academy site at techinaid.com/courses or sign up for my newsletter on the techinaid.com website to get all the updates. Now let's continue with our video. In Backstage, I'm just going to go ahead and create from a template, and I have this new GKE cluster. Remember, I have my platform engineering hat, so I'm going to generate or create a GKE cluster using this template. And this template will ideally only be accessible to platform engineers and not developers. Of course, you can change that if you want, but using RBAC, which I don't show here, you can specify and say only certain team can access this template. So I'm going to put in my owner, organization, user for GitHub and a repository, which I'm going to create for this deployment. I'm going to click next to take me to basics of the GKE cluster that I want to create. So I'm going to give it a name. The region is US Central 1. I can choose between US East and US Central 1. Of course, this is configurable in your template. I'm going to choose E2 small. I can choose medium as well, but we'll choose small. And the node count is the number of nodes per AZ. Okay, we'll go ahead and review. All looks good to me. Let's go ahead and click create. And this will publish this into a repository and trigger a GitHub action, which we'll just see in just a couple of minutes. So if I go to the repository, I can quickly see that the repository that got generated is called GKE Sam inside of my GitHub account. I'll make this bigger. And there's an XR claim right here. So this XR claim is a Crossplane definition here for a cluster in GKE, and it automatically grabbed the information from the Backstage template and added it into this definition here, this manifest. So the cluster name, the region, the machine type, and the node count per AZ all is over here. That's great. Now, if I jump into my actions, GitHub actions, repo, this is a different repo under Crossplane GKE. I can see that there is a 1 minute ago, a GitHub action workflow just ran. So if I go in here, I can take a look and see it's successful. So if I go in here to quickly see the job, set up the job, checking out the code, installing ArgoCD CLI, logging into ArgoCD, registering the repository in ArgoCD, the one we just saw, and then checking the directory, deploying the cluster with ArgoCD, and that's it. So with that, I can jump into my ArgoCD dashboard. And again, here we go. I can see that this app in ArgoCD is deployed. It's using GitOps principles for infrastructure, which is neat because now I'm going to see that my cluster here, here's my application, some details about my application. It's running inside of my infrastructure Kubernetes cluster where I have ArgoCD, Crossplane, Backstage, everything is running here. And I got my repo that I just showed you earlier where the XR claim is. It's creating a namespace and everything else. This looks great. Parameters, manifests, events. So manifest, this is the application manifest in ArgoCD. So the repo URL I just showed you earlier, and it's the destination server is going to be that infrastructure server I just mentioned. The X cluster that I mentioned here, this came from a composition. It's a claim, and you can see it here. This is the live manifest, and here's the desired manifest. It's already synced, and you can see successfully composed resources here, and this is creating a cluster and a node pool. So the cluster, you can see the event for the, or you can see the manifest for the cluster right here, right? And then the event successfully requested the creation of this external resource. And it's going to take some time, of course, to get that created. And here's our node pool as well. And the events, it cannot resolve this because it's waiting. Referencing resource may not yet be ready. It's still waiting on the cluster to finish to be able to create the node pool. So we're going to give this some time. In the meantime, if I go into the GCP console, I can see that my cluster is being generated right here. So this is going to take a little bit of time before it's ready. So we'll pause the video and we'll come back after. All right, our cluster is complete. It's already been generated. I'm going to grab the name of this cluster because I'm going to need to register it in ArgoCD. So let's copy that. Real quick, we can go look at ArgoCD. You can see it right here. Oops, I got kicked out. Yeah, everything's synced. Everything looks good. So let's go ahead and register this cluster inside of ArgoCD. But before we do that, I need to grab the context. So let's go ahead and replace this with a new cluster. There we go. So run this gcloud command. This will give us the new context. So we got the new context right here. And then this command is what's going to allow us to register into ArgoCD. Remember, I'm still the platform engineer persona. So you're going to do this once. You're probably going to have a few clusters that you're going to allow your developers to work with. So you can choose to do this manually as I'm doing it right now, or you can probably automate it as well if you wish. Okay. And now we've got these two commands in here. Now let's check to make sure that the cluster has been successfully registered. So if you go to settings in ArgoCD and you go to clusters, here we go. We've got our GKE dev cluster, and I've got the URL of this cluster, which I'm going to need. So I'm going to copy that. All right. I do notice, though, that if you go back to clusters, it says unknown connection status. Don't worry about that for now. That will turn to successful just in a little bit. Okay. Now we got to update the Go API template. This is going to be used, this template in Backstage is going to be used for our application. So if you're going to have multiple templates, let's say Node.js, Python, all these templates that you're going to generate, you probably want to update them with the new GKE cluster that you want your developers to deploy their applications into. I'm assuming that as a platform engineer, I'm not going to give the developers the option of where to deploy. I'm in control of my clusters, so I am going to force them to deploy into the clusters that I choose. That could change if you want to give them that flexibility. You can obviously do that as well. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and update my Go API template. So I've got it here in this repo, and I'm going to look for it under packages and under backend and under templates. Go API right here and under template over here. This is where I will look for the Kubernetes cluster URL for Argo. This one, I'm going to change it like that. And that should do it. And now I can just go ahead and push that into my repo. So updated new GKE cluster URL. And this template is not available yet in Backstage. We are getting it ready to deploy it for our developers, okay? So now let's take a look at our next step. Yep, so now we got to register this API template component into our Backstage UI. And this is the URL of this template, which is basically in this repo that I'm in. Under the packages, backend templates, Go API template, that's the actual URL. So I need to go into Backstage right now and register it. So if I go back to my Backstage instance here, and we're going to go ahead and click create, register existing component. Notice it's not available just yet. So register an existing component, giving it the URL, analyze, looks good, import that. And that's it. So if I go back to create, there it is, new Go API. If you go back to the catalog under kind template, you'll see my templates. Here's my new Go API template. If I click this pencil icon, it'll take me to exactly the template that we just worked on. And if you go to the bottom, here is the GKE cluster that we defined. Okay. And that is pretty much it for this demo for today in terms of the workflow that we did. And now it's going to be time for understanding the magic that happened behind the scenes, how this all worked. So we'll go into the configuration and explain how I got all of this to work. First off, we'll take a look at the template, the GKE cluster template, and it's under my templates folder in the backend folder under packages. And as we saw before with templates, we're giving it a name, a title, and this is what's going to allow us to use Crossplane to build this. So what we're going to do is we're going to set a few parameters. The first one is choosing the repo location. So giving it the repo URL, asking the user to use the or put in the repo URL. And the title here, we're going to look at the cluster name, the region, machine type, node count. This is the configuration for the GKE cluster itself. And remember, the persona here is the platform engineer. So we built this template for ourselves or other platform engineers to build GKE clusters. The cluster name, the region, machine type, node count, these are all properties. So you can see the type string for all these numbers for the node count. And we're also specifying the choices that you can take, right? Enum, and then it's either US East 1 or US Central 1, the dropdown that we saw in the demo. And then steps. First off, we're going to fetch this template. And really the URL here is the content in here. And what's inside this content folder is this XR claim that I showed you before, and we're feeding in some parameters that we defined. So the cluster name, the region, machine type, and the node count. These variables are all getting fed into here. And this is a a claim for our composition in Crossplane of type of kind X cluster. And the metadata here, you see the name. We're grabbing all this information from the template, from the parameters in the template. And then we're going to publish the contents of the working directory to GitHub. The content here, which is this particular file, gets published into GitHub. And here's the repo that we just created, the repo URL that we just grabbed from the user. And then finally, we're going to trigger a GitHub action workflow. So we need to specify the action is a dispatch. The workflow ID, this is the name of the workflow that we have in the Crossplane GKE repo. And we're tying into the main branch. And these are the workflow inputs that the workflow needs, the GitHub Actions workflow. Cluster name, region, machine type, node count, and the repo URL for Argo. All these are needed. And the output for the template is the repository that we have. Now let's take a look at the GitHub Actions workflow that got just triggered. So here it is. I'm in a different repo. This repo is the GKE Crossplane repo that we saw before. And in here, I can see that I have a dispatch. It's on workflow dispatch, which means it's a manual dispatch for the workflow, and I've got the inputs that I exported from the template. So the cluster name, the region, machine type, node count, and the repo URL for Argo. I've got the jobs here. These are the different steps for the job. I'm running Ubuntu latest, and I'm checking out the code. Then I'm installing the ArgoCD CLI, logging into ArgoCD. I have the secrets inside of the Argo, inside of the workflow or the GitHub Actions secrets. And then I'm registering the repository in ArgoCD. And this is just for debugging to see where I am. We're probably going to remove it. And then finally, deploying the cluster with ArgoCD. So here's the command, the ArgoCD command to deploy the cluster. So you can see where we're deploying this cluster. And really what's important to note is the repo. This is the repo where we saw the XR claim. And then the destination is the local server, the local Kubernetes API for what I use for my infrastructure cluster. Then we have a namespace that we're going to create here. And then we're going to create this namespace since it doesn't exist just yet. And now let's take a quick look at our Crossplane setup here in Kubernetes. I'm not going to spend too much time on this since I have a dedicated video going into a whole lot of details. So in here, I've got my bare metal K3S cluster that's running in my lab. And I can go ahead and look at kubectl get x cluster. Here's my x cluster, kubectl get cluster itself. It's right here. And kubectl get node tool. I can see that as well. So of course, that X cluster is responsible for the managed resources here, the cluster and node pool right here. And that's it for this video. We saw how we were able to use GitOps principles with ArgoCD to deploy infrastructure using Crossplane's composite claim. The same way we'll be deploying our application as the developer persona in our next video. So stay tuned for that.